I welcome you to this first video of my modeling and texturing series. I have a plan to do a lot of modeling and texturing small classes here. Please keep watching these things. And this is the first video of the series where I'm going to show you a very basic model of a table and chair. So let me show you that image. So this is the model we are going to do. And this course is for complete beginners. If you know a little bit my modeling still, I'll say just watch these videos, you might learn some new thing. So let's start doing these things. So I'm going to do this table first. So here I'm using Maya 2018, which is the latest version here. If you don't have Maya 2018, still you can follow me. I'm not going to show you some very specific option which Maya 28 has. So if you are using Maya 2017 or 16, you can still do it. It's a very simple object. So let's first start doing the table top, which is this part. So which is a very simple basic cubical shapes, square. So the first thing, let me just show you, if you want to do anything inside 3D, you need to just think about the basic shape and try to find it here, or you can go to create menu and you can find some polygon primitives here. So when I say primitives, it's the basic shapes you can see here, the starting points. So most of the time you are going to start from a primitive. So here I'm going to use this cube because this is the closest shape. So when you click on the primitives from the self here, it's going to appear on the grid origin here. This is this grid center part is called origin, so it appears here. So then I'm going to get that proportion. You can see this is obviously not like a cube. It has a width, depth and a height. So I'm just saying this part, let's say width, and the opposite is depth, and this small the up down thing is height. Okay, so you can see now a cube is like a cube has same height, width and depth. So let's go to channel box first. So if you go here and you can click on this icon, which is I think this icon, it's gonna give you this channel box and layer editor. So let me just drag and drop here. When it's blue, just release it, so it's gonna stack here. Okay, you can see here the channel box. Now my model is selected. You can see the big cube one. Now if I go to inputs and click on polycube here, just watch me, just click here, you can see a lot of options here. Now I'm gonna use some options to modify the shape. So let's say the width. So I can modify this by two ways. I can just click here and put some value, like let's say 3, like this. So this is width. The x axis is the width direction here, and the z axis or the g axis is the depth here. So when I increase or decrease the width, it's gonna stress the cube in x axis. So let's say 5. Okay, and now this 5 is 5 centimeter. Okay, if you're wondering what is that, how you are gonna say it, so 5 means 5 centimeter. Maya is set to centimeter by default. If you want to change it, you can change inside, but I'm not going to tell you that right now because I'm not going to confuse you. So that's not that much necessary right now. So just let's put 5 here, or let's put maybe 4 in the depth, and let's put 1 or maybe in the height, something. So you can change this value by just adding a numerical value here, or you can just click here or any of the name here which you want to modify. Just click the name. Once it's highlighted, keep the cursor on this view somewhere in the like blank area and hold your middle mouse button and drag. When you hold your middle mouse and drag, it's gonna change that value. Okay, so The only difference is you can see when you are changing the value interactively. So sometimes it's helpful. When I don't know what is the amount I really need to put, I just click here and middle mouse drag and I see which thickness I like. Here, let's say I like this. Okay, so try to get the proportion first. Try to see whether it's a square cube or it's a very rectangle type of table. Okay, once you get it, then let's see it closely. So when I let's zoom it, always check your image properly. You can see here it doesn't have a very straight profile. You can see it has a straight profile here, and then you can see a very like narrowing shape here. So we can do that by just adding a segment here in the height area. Then I can scale the bottom face. So let's put a subdivision in the height area. So now it has one. So let's put two. See, I got new segments here. So then I can just go to face mode by just right clicking and go to face mode and select the bottom face and go to scale tool, then scale from the center. So I'm trying to get that profile which has this straight and then narrowing down. Okay, so how to use primitives as a starting point and then how we can modify the inputs to change the shape or proportion, then we learn how we can get a narrowing shape by just adding a segment and changing a face or scaling a face. Okay, so in the next lesson we are going to do the legs and the other things or the part of the table. Okay, I'll see you there.